In this video, I am talking about Spider-Man Homecoming, the fact that it's the beginning of a trilogy, and what will happen with Sony and Marvel after their contract. What is up, YouTube? It's Josh. This is the Den of Nerds. Guys, there's a ton of news dropping about Spider-Man Homecoming, which of course is coming out right around the corner. I am personally really, really excited about this movie. I have kind of shunned off all the rest of the trailers and promotion, though, because I feel like this movie is like telling its whole story online. So I haven't really been covering a lot of the Homecoming stuff because I haven't been watching it. I'm trying to keep a little bit of surprise in, I guess, you know, the experience. So I'm not doing all of that. But there have been some interesting news. Now, before I get into all of the news, I do want to do a slight show notes / channel update sort of thing. If you'll notice, the uploads have been kind of infrequent as of late. I am actually out of town. I'm recording this video in Pittsburgh. I live in Philadelphia, and I'm going to Origins Game Fair this weekend, and I'm literally just taking the week off. So this will be the last video I do for the Den of Nerds, unless I slip something in there that's real crazy that I really, really, really want to cover. But Justin and Dan are taking over the channel for the next couple of days. They now have access to the YouTube channel and some editing software, so they have the comm, as it were. So feel free to hit them up on all their social media if you want certain videos or if you have questions or problems or concerns about the Den. Hit them up, berate them with your comments, and hopefully they'll be inspired to make some videos and it'll be really cool. Now, just real quick, I do want to mention there's a lot of changes happening to the Den of Nerds behind the scenes, and in the next couple of weeks, we're going to be making a lot of announcements, which I think you guys are going to find very exciting. It's been about a year since I started this YouTube channel. I've changed a lot in that year. This channel has changed a lot in that year, and we as a team now have big plans for what we want to do for the rest of this year. So stay tuned, and thank you everyone who has shown support by watching, sharing videos, all of the likes, the everything. Honestly, thank you guys so much for the support, and we're going to take some big steps. Now, let's get into this Spider-Man craziness. Now, a story broke a couple days ago about how Spider-Man Homecoming is indeed going to be the beginning of a trilogy. So there will be a trilogy of films that will be Spider-Man 1, 2, and 3. It's not going to be Homecoming 2 and 3. It's going to be Spider-Man 2 and 3. Now, that's kind of an interesting thing in the light of the announcement that this Sony Marvel Universe, the SMU, which I, of course, touched on in my Tom Hardy as Venom video, is completely separate from the arrangement that they have with the MCU. Several days ago, it was confirmed by Kevin Feige, who said that there's no plans to bring Venom into the MCU at this time, that it is a Sony project. So there it is, black and white, plain as day. It's completely separate than the arrangement they have with Spider-Man for the current MCU version of the character. Now, I've talked about this at length, and I have, you know, a lot of concerns about what it would mean for Sony to take back over Spider-Man completely. I think that it's a terrible idea, but having said that, I am interested in what they'll do with this Venom picture. But I think that Tom Holland has a 6-movie contract with the MCU. So if we count Civil War on that, and then we count Avengers 3 and 4, then the Spider-Man Homecoming films would be the remainder of his MCU contract. So essentially, we're going to be living in a world where Spider-Man is showing up in Marvel films as Sony is building the SMU. So they're going to be happening at the same time. So this is going to be kind of weird. How are they going to solve this problem? Is Peter Parker, Tom Holland, going to be a part of the Sony Marvel Universe? Is that going to then like pseudo tie it all together, even though Venom is not in the MCU, because Spider-Man is and they play in the same universe that he's in the continuity? I'm not really sure. This is all really, really bizarre and interesting stuff. Now, as far as the movie itself being a trilogy, I think that one of the problems with the Sam Raimi trilogy, you know, and a lot of this falls to Sony, is that I think it was on pace to tell like straight through line story about Peter and his development into the Spider-Man and what that meant for his life and his friends and family. But it goes completely off the rails by just throwing in a bunch of these villains. Now, here's the thing. Spider-Man has an awesome rogues gallery, and I almost wish that they weren't doing a trilogy and they were just going to do separate kind of little mini stories that involve Peter. So unless the Vulture and the Sinister Six are going to play a huge role in this entire trilogy, then I think it's kind of a waste to go the trilogy route. I'm not a big fan of that, because if they introduce all new villains and like all new things, it just loses kind of the fabric that holds a great trilogy together. Like the Lord of the Rings works because it's a single story about a single villain and a single evil that they're trying to overcome. It's the same thing with Star Wars. It's a single vision, single story about a single evil that they're trying to overcome. And I think that the oomph gets lost, like for instance, even in the Captain America trilogies, even though that ties together pretty nicely, it doesn't really feel like a trilogy. It's not a trilogy. You know what I mean? Like, it's not an overarching story. So, I don't know. For them to go the trilogy route, I really trust in Feige. I trust in the Marvel team and what they have with Sony. I just really hope. This is my big concern. This is the last point I'll make in the video. I really hope that none of this is posturing. That nothing that will be done in Spider-Man 2 and 3 will be posturing to try to position Marvel to get a better deal when they re-sign. If they re-sign, and I really hope that the development of a Tom Hardy Venom movie is not simply posturing and leverage for Sony to get more the next time they sign, if they sign. If that is what is going on here, the people that really lose are the fans. This arrangement between Marvel and Sony is like super unprecedented and represents what's best for the fans, and that is in it of itself the reason that we as fans should want it to continue. I see no reason why the SMU and the MCU can't be connected, just like Marvel and Marvel Max, and you know, you got your X-Men books over here, and you got your Inhumans books over here, and all that. I think that that's fine, and I think they could do crossovers or all sorts of interesting things. And we are heading, guys, towards a dangerous place with the MCU, because this templated formula that they use is kind of getting droll. It's kind of getting to this place where I want to see something different. I want to see more stakes. I want to see better villains. I want to see a little more darkness. Stuff that the MCU kind of hasn't really given us. It's done a great job of bringing these heroes to life in this connected world. It's beautiful. I'm so fanboyishly in love what they've done, especially when you look at what the Distinguished Competition has done over there. I mean, we could have a mess of that, and instead we have this really nice continuity, which is dope. But it's getting a little bit boring. So what are they going to do to appease the hardcore fan? You know, I think they need to do stuff like the Sony deal. I think they need to reach out to Fox and come to some kind of arrangement and share all of these characters. Feige wants the comic book experience to be the movie experience, that you could see any of these characters join up. And as a writer, and I think what would be most interesting is when they get to the point where maybe it's not in phases anymore, maybe they're just letting good filmmakers make and tell interesting stories, and then they have access as the writers and creators to all of these different toys that they want to play with. I think that's the cool stuff. That's where a lot of the flavor for the comic books comes in. So that's what I want to see happen. But as of yet, guys, this is the big news. Spider-Man Homecoming is going to be a trilogy. That is likely the end of the Marvel-Sony relationship unless they re-sign. And the Sony Marvel Universe, which is completely separate than the MCU, is going to be developed while these other films are still going on. So what do you guys think about that? Let me know in the comment section. Are you excited for a trilogy? Do you think that's a nice way to wrap up maybe Tom Holland's story, to make way for this Sony Marvel thing? Do you think that it's all posturing? They are going to end up working together and figuring this thing out? Super interested to hear your guys' thoughts in the comment section below, as always. So I hope you are having an awesome and nerdy day. See ya!